हेलो, वेलकम टू इन 5 मिनट्स। इट्स टू ऑल सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन पी जे फेट, पी चैनल जे फेट बेस्ड एसी प्रॉब्लम्स। नाउ द क्वेश्चन गिवन ओवर हियर, व्हेन यू लुक एट द डायग्राम कैन सी दिस इज द सिंपल गिवन फ्रॉम द बुक नीमन। द एरो मूविंग आउटवर्ड्स इंडिकेट्स दैट इट इज पी चैनल जे फेट। Then to identify it belongs to which configuration, the three possible configurations are common source, common gate, and common drain. Now how to identify to which configuration it belongs? Look at the input port. When you look over here, VI is applied to which terminal? Can see this is your gate, this is your source, and this is your drain. Input is applied to the gate, so we can say input to gate, output we are taking from drain. Which terminal is left out is the common terminal. In this we are not using the source terminal. You have gate, drain, and source. We are not using source, so it becomes common source configuration. That is the first one. Now the question tells us that the transistor parameters are IDSS, that is drain to source saturation current 8 milliamperes, pinch off voltage is given as 4 volts, lambda is given as 0. Since lambda is 0, it indicates your output resistance is infinite. So we need not consider the output resistance in the analysis. They are telling us to design the circuit such that the quiescent current is 4 milliampere and drain to source voltage is 7.5 volts and the voltage gain is given as minus 3 and the total resistance R1 plus R2 as 400 kilo ohms. So we need to find out the value of RS, RD, R1 and R2. They have given us the Q point, that is the quiescent parameters, and the AC gain. From this we need to find out the value of R1, R2, RS and RD. First of all we need to do the DC analysis. Now in order to mark the points, you can say this is plus, this is minus, so it becomes V, S, G, and this is plus, this is minus, becomes V, S, T. Your source is more positive as compared to drain. In the n-channel we write it as VDS and VGS, right? Now solving using the Schauffele's equation, you know the Schauffele's equation is ID equals to IDSS, that is drain to source saturation current, 1 minus VSG by VP the whole square. Now VSG, why we are writing it as VSG? Since it is P channel. If it would have been N channel, we would have written it as VGS. What is the value of ID given in the question? When you look here, ID is given as 4 milliampere and IDS is 8 and VP 4. So substituting the values, ID is given as 4 milliampere. So 4 into 10 raised to minus 3. 8 milliampere is our IDSS and 1 minus VGS by VP. VGS, VSG we don't know. So VSG upon VP, that is 4, the whole square. So from this we'll get VSG as 1.17 volts. So when you solve the above equation, you'll get VSG as 1.17 volts. Now when you apply KVL in the drain source loop, that is you have the source resistance, you have the drain resistance, and then it is connected to ground. Here you have plus VDD, which is given as 20 volts. Here you have RS, RD. This is P channel. Here you have plus minus VSD. So when you apply KVL in drain source loop, your equation will be KVL to drain source loop. What will be the equation in this case? It will be VDD minus IDQ into RS minus VSDQ, then minus IDQ into this is RD drain resistance equals to 0. So from this what we'll get, know the value of VDD, you know the value of IDQ, PSDQ and IDQ. So substituting the values, can write VSD as VDD minus ID into RS plus RD. VSD is given as 7.5, VDD is given as 20, IDQ is given as 4 milliamperes and RS plus RD. So from this you can find RS plus RD equals to 3.125 kilo ohms. So you got RS plus RD as 3.125 kilo ohms.